tired. My brain's not working properly.
Your brain working properly. There's a joke in there, but I'm too shagged to think of it.
Good.
Only half an hour to go to end of shift. If we just hide out here, we'll be okay.
That's your fault, that is.
Fuck. Actual moonlight. You've got to be joking.
Catch. Useless.
Health and safety. Very loud music. Stadium loud. Plus, it's likely to be stadium loud shit music.
I'll get the equipment ready. For the patient. My ears are sensitive, man.
Great. A club full of comedowns waiting to happen. Why do human beings insist on searching after highs? News just in, highs generate lows. Life is not a roller coaster. I repeat, life is not a roller coaster.
Come here. Dance with me.
No, I'm not that great a dancer.
You worry too much.
Life is a nice, smooth escalator ride from forceps to grave. See a few films, read a few books, bit of sex along the way, ideally. Drink or two with mates, fine.
Hello? What's you been drinking? Water?
No, Red Bull. We don't let them drink too much water.
Reckon it's hypothermia.
But if you really want the roller coaster version, then don't whinge to me about the stress. Because no matter how high you go, no matter how in the moment you may get, you're already on your way back down. And when you fall, you better be ready to land.
Fuck!
Oh, are you all right?
No, that bloody hurt.
The big fireman.
Okay, remembering I'm terminally single and that other people's romantic stuff is an intensely boring subject, how are things with you and Craig?
Well, you know I've been looking for a bloke for a while now. Good bloke. One will make me happy, rest of my life kind of thing.
Yeah.
Well, I think I've cracked it.
Oh dear. I think I've seen bliss.
Afraid so.
Any units available? Multi-storey car park at the A1 junction with York Road. Large-scale outrage to public decency in progress.
Outrage to public decency.
Man trapped in car performing sexual act.
Sounds like a dogging to me.
Of course it does, Miss Marple.
Why do we have to attend a dogging?
Back seizure. Oh, fuck. Can't take the van up.
What, we're walking up all those stairs?
I'm going to wait in the van. My feet hurt. I got a blister.
Love is a many a splendid thing, don't you think?
Sword that doesn't quite capture this.
9-100, female trapped in car under male with final injury. I've got to get out of here. I've got Ofsted tomorrow.
You are aware that you're breaking the law, madam.
Is my husband still here? It's a blue Renault Espace.
Lovers in the 80.
Maybe for some eye.
Message received.
There's no spas.
That arsehole. And you, if you've got ruptured discs, you should have informed the community there are rules here. And you've got shit-tasting music.
Wait till you're out of the car to beat him up. You'll get a much better swing on your punch.
We're gonna cut you out. We'll be quick as we can, OK?
We're going to have to take the roof off, but it's keeping him calm while we cut.
Right. Tricky.
I have the solution. OK, I have a little syringe here. It's just some relaxant with a bit of painkiller thrown in.
I can't do needles. Are you going to do it now?
Nope, not yet. I tell you...
Ah!
When?
Fuck you!
You're welcome. You'll feel it kicking in quite soon. Breathe, yeah?
Yeah.
You not giving the jab the real stuff?
I'm not qualified. He thinks he's been injected, it's all in the head.
Nice one.
He'll soon work it out in about 10 minutes, then he'll be panicking like fuck.
Are Maxine and Craig?
I believe they are, yeah.
When?
It's a very recent development.
Didn't see that coming.
No.
She's been running them down the station.
Well, it depends. Feeling generous all of a sudden. While they're cutting these two out, we could have a quickie in the engine.
Yeah, I think that'd probably send out the wrong message.
Spoil sport.
Gaffer, come and have a look at this!
I thought we'd never get him out.
You all right about that, Maxine and Craig?
Yeah, she's happy, so I'm pleased. She's a good mate. Been mates since uni.
Well, that'll change.
Will it? Why?
He's not going to want you crowding the scene, is he? Just saying.
He's not going to want you around. Suppose not.
Thanks so much for not arresting me.
You got Ofsted tomorrow. And I like teachers. The last thing we want is less teachers in the classroom because that means more feral kids on the streets and more paperwork.
Only I'm not a teacher. I'm an inspector.
OK, turn the car around. Is cell number 5-3?
What?
I'm joking. Oh, look. Lewis Bass.
Yeah, this is the one.
OK, this is a caution. The next time, it probably won't be us. You will be arrested and charged, and it will go on your record. Can I ask you something?
What?
You're a professional woman. A charge of public indecency, it would wreck your career. Why risk it?
I thought it'd take me out of myself. Lose control a bit, you know? Stop me worrying. Relieve the stress.
Well, I think it's safe to say that it didn't.
The opposite.
Ah! There you are, Shirley. You were a long time. Down the shops.
Oh, shut up, you gutless dickwad. Go and pour me a glass of red, a large.
Should we get back and do some paperwork then?
Yeah. Come on. I'm on a roll.
I'm getting anxious just reading the sign.
Bollocks bingo.
Yeah, come on.
What's that?
10 words, subject specific.
Big words. And but don't count.
Tell you what stress is.
Stress is a fucking gravy train.
Stress. In engineering, stress is what happens when a piece of metal
fails. Genius, well done.
Because maybe there's a fault in the metal that no one detected. It's a bit like that with humans. So we experience stress when we fail to adequately deal with the emotional demands made on us by life.
Jesus, this is petrifying.
Now, the underlying causes of stress may not always be the obvious ones.
Two words or one? I've got that down as one.
It's the hidden stuff. It's the stuff we ignore. The insidious causes.
Insidious? Insidious. Cool.
My guess is that you're all pretty well functional human beings. You must be. It's stressful work tending sick and vulnerable people. Incredibly long shifts, limited resources. You all have tried and tested coping mechanisms.
Got that.
And, of course, there's always been support available. Those things.
Support. Hey, support, yeah, easy.
And the support that we provide, they prevent the negative effects of stress from impinging on your well-being.
Impinging.
But,
well-being.
But so often,
we don't stand a chance with.
And to prioritize.
House.
So, what happens when things change? When new situations arise. Unfamiliar emotions that threaten to overwhelm your tried and tested coping mechanisms. Metal starts to crack. Little cracks at first, but unchecked, they grow. They spread. We need to be looking out for each other. Watching for the little warning signs of stress in our colleagues.
A fucking piece of cake. Every move you make is a sign of stress.
Not in an invasive way. Just let's look out for our mates. And if you spot any of those telltale signs,
then you report them to me so they can be dealt with.
Supported. Encouraged to talk through the problem.
During your lunch break.
Or at a time of their convenience when their shift is over, yes?
Yes.
Yes.
But it won't count as overtime.
That was generous of us, letting him off with just a caution.
Yeah, well, before you ask, no, I have not gone soft. The woman had no previous, she won't be back.
You all right?
Yeah, it's just...
What?
I sent him a text, he's not replied.
When?
Last night at the dogging.
Well, give him a chance.
Yeah, I know, and he's still on shift, so...
You seeing him tonight?
No, tomorrow. It's just the text I sent him, it were a bit full on. I'm just going to text him again. And
that'll be two of yours, yeah?
Yeah. It will.
OK. Here's what's happening. Stuart is in denial about Dibble fucking Trumpton.
Do you even know who Dibble is or where Trumpton's located?
Irrelevant. You're in denial about the policewoman and the fireboy.
Splendid theory. One flaw, it's balls.
Well, my splendid theory actually includes the idea that you think it were balls because you're in denial.
So I can't critique your theory?
No. Stick that in your pipe.
Can I critique it? Yeah. It's balls.
I haven't finished yet.
To what? We're just going to get bigger balls.
Yeah,
You're obsessed, aren't you?
Okay, go on.
He's in denial about his best mate and the fireman being an item. And the more he keeps it up, the more pain he'll have to...
Suppress?
Suppress, bingo. So it'll bubble up as stress. And how will we know? He'll be a complete fucking arse to work with.
He generally is, though, anyway. He's a prickly fuckwit.
See, I don't mind the prickly bit. Rash, if you're trying to get me to break my back to show you how fucking serene I can be just to prove you wrong, you can forget it. It ain't gonna happen.
Shit. Rumbled.
Yeah.
Good try.
Look, I don't experience stress. It's programmed out. Nothing I see in this job throws me from my equilibrium.
What about when you're away from work?
Away from work?
Yeah, I believe it's called life.
Again, nothing throws me. Life is smooth and easy.
I'm fuck boring.
Man 62, hit by a falling tree. Assistance required.
Here we go again.
Just briefly, are you okay, though? Truly?
Don't know. Never seen Maxine in love before. She never has been. It's totally new territory.
Good, isn't it? Payback.
You made an effort. I'm very impressed.
Superb. You are so close to becoming a fully fucked up member of the EMT fraternity.
It's not just a gag, though. That is a therapeutic tool.
A therapeutic tool?
Mm-hmm. I'm trying to flush it out. All the hurt you're hiding.
Why?
You can't leave all that jealous shit sitting inside you. Plus, I'm out with the FIU today. Taking piss out is going to give Ashley something to laugh about. You're there to cheer Ashley up.
So I'm the therapeutic tool?
Got it in one.
Since when have I been jealous?
Dear, oh dear. Look at the tool. Don't take your eyes off that tool. Keep your eyes on the tool!
Hiya. Morning, you all right?
Yeah.
Busy day ahead? Buffing up your pool?
No, I've got someone to do that for me nowadays.
When she's not texting me, that is.
Charming. Do you fancy meeting for lunch?
Okay. What do you have in mind?
I'll come to you, hang with the Strapping Fire Boys.
Okay. Well, see you later.
All right, I'll see you. Trained to be a bloody nurse.
Do you want a coffee?
No, thank you, sir.
Oh, I'd love a coffee, mate.
Do you want me to get you one?
No, can't. Caffeine. Better watch the ticker. Anyway, I'm having to lose 3 more beat officers this month.
Yeah. Shit, I'm not for the chop, am I, sir?
No way. You're a female. Got my quotas to worry about. I've been encouraged to suspend admission to the detective inspector course for the next 2 years. Freeze folk in their posts for a while.
But you're not going...
Yes, I am. Just not yet. I have 2 places left. One's already got a name on it. I want you on the other one. Okay?
Yeah. Yeah.
Domestic fight.
2 females, mid-20s.
Do we have to attend a hair-pulling contest?
Patients appear to be of Russian descent.
Fuck. We're going in there without police protection.
Bet they're fighting over some bloke.
Back it in!
Is she getting the better of you?
She ran with an 8-foot plank of wood.
Aww.
You want me to leave you along with her?
No, thank you.
Calm down, yeah? Chill.
chill, yes, chill now. And then I get her!
Okay, that remark alone guarantees you a stay in the cells.
It's only a joke.
Yeah, well, look at my face, I'm laughing. English, please.
She says you need to get fucked more often!
Huh, advice, how kind!
Come on, ladies, let's go.
Little does she know you are getting fucked more often.
Indeed.
So how's it going with the fireman?
What, you really want to know? You're not going to find it boring. It's really weird, Stu. It's incredible. Lovely. Like, butterflies in my stomach. I can't stop thinking about him. The whole deal. That's what love does to you.
Serotonin, actually.
Serotonin?
It's a neural messenger.
Oh, Stuart, what are we going to do with you?
I'm serious. It sends all the emotional messages around the brain. If I had an fMRI scanner handy, I'd show you.
And you don't? Some mate.
They don't load us with that kind of hardware, but if they did, do you know what you'd see? The serotonin clustered in the brain in a way that you only see in two types. Sappy, loved-up bastards like you.
Yeah.
And patients with OCD.
Is that so?
It's an obsession, isn't it? You said so yourself. I can't stop thinking about him.
Yeah?
Love's just brain chemistry. There are labs where they can synthesize that kind of feeling into pill form.
Oh, Stuart. You're such a loser. I've got some more good news. I'm taking the preliminaries for the DI course.
Fuck. That's fantastic. Saying like everything you've worked towards ever. Really moving on.
It's going to be hard, though. I've got to pass a whole load of tests, pass a few interviews, then I've got the course itself. It's pretty intensive.
Yeah, but you're brilliant at that shit. You eat stuff like that for breakfast. I always have done. The bizarre thing is, I think you'll actually enjoy it.
Yeah.
Stuart, we need to get Anna Karenina and I hear T&E.
Okay, small announcement to make, no fuss or anything, but that hurt a bit, talking to Maxine.
Fuck. Is that an actual real emotion?
Yeah.
And you're planning to talk to me about it?
I know, what the fuck am I thinking?
Go on.
Well, I just thought we'd carry on, you know, her and me being mates. Silly, I suppose.
And so how does this make you feel?
I think I'm a little bit disappointed with her.
Disappointed?
Hmm.
What? It grieves me to say this, but could Rashid be right for once?
Right how?
It's jealousy. It's stressing you out?
No.
Okay.
No, I'm not jealous.
Great. Can we stop being sincere now? It's freaking me out.
Absolutely.
Got some major news.
Oh yeah, go on.
Yeah, I'll tell you about it over lunch.
About lunch.
Yeah.
Well, it's just that I'm with all the guys. They're a pretty laddish bunch, you know. We could do dinner. That'd be nice. You talk properly, you can tell me your news.
Yeah. Yeah, that'd be not fine.
There's a shout. Look, I'm sorry, I've got to go, we've got a call.
Oh. Okay, well, I...
Right. Yeah, see you later.
See ya. Okay.
All right, message received.
Drunk and disorderly. I bet we run into Ashley again. Drunk's probably fallen over or someone's hit him or something. We're just in curse to keep bumping into each other. Hey, everything all right?
Yeah. Are you hoping you'll run into Ashley?
Not quite.
I'll go in and draw him. You take his Amaran. So what's this all about, mate?
I'm protesting against cuts.
Shouldn't that be a bank or something?
Tried that. It's warm when it's getting here.
Just hand it over. It's early in the morning to be dishammered, isn't it?
That is such a shit joke.
Oh, well, how's that putting the hammer down before someone gets hurt?
Get her up, all right? Doesn't have to go that way, mate.
Fuck.
Careful, Ryan!
What the fuck was that? Did she just zap me? I'll have you, darling. Police complaints, Commissioner!
Dream on, sunshine. Just a bit of a wobble, that's all.
Fucking lost it. I didn't even issue him a warning.
Sergeant? I want you to see the boss. And I booked your roleplay sessions. Let's start the promotion process. You all right?
Yeah, yes. Most definitely.
Excellent.
Ah, good. You answered. Look, I need to have a word. It can't wait, so if you've got time... The cafe. Great, I'll see you in 15.
You actually deployed a taser? Well, no point having a toy if you can't play with it occasionally.
It's not funny.
What's on your mind?
You know how I've always taken stuff in my stride, like everything I've ever achieved?
Yeah, in like an uber-effective way, which actually terrifies me.
Yeah, well, I'm feeling really stressed, and right now that is not good. It's like... suddenly my judgment's gone out the window, and this DI course... I really want to get it.
And you will. You have faith in your abilities, don't you?
Yeah.
Hang on. There was a pause there, and not quite convincing, yeah.
This is the big one, Stuart, all right? It's the real deal.
Every stage has been the real deal. Why are you suddenly losing confidence?
I don't know. It's just... Oh, fuck it. It'll be fine. A little bit of stress is good.
Yeah, a bit of stress. I still don't see why this is different, why things have changed suddenly.
Thanks.
How's everything else?
Yeah, it's good. Craig's really pleased.
Yeah?
Yeah. I mean, I think he is. I mean, he doesn't show it so much, but he's not so... demonstrative. Oh, I just don't know. It's like, sometimes he's not that into me. He doesn't reply to my texts, he cancels our dates. I just don't know where I stand.
Maxine?
Yeah?
I've kind of been watching the pair of you. Like at the car park, on the junction with the A1 at the York Road.
Oh, yeah?
Well, you forget I know all about body language, and I was watching the non-verbal signs you were sending each other. He fucking adores you.
How do you know?
The signs. The way he looks at you when you're not looking at him. The way he holds himself when you're stood there. He's still trying to win you.
Yeah, well, he could fucking text me more often.
The fucking mobile phone is a feeder of anxiety like this. You don't need those kind of signs. It's the non-verbal stuff that matters. He's crazy about you.
Thanks.
Good. Panic over, yeah?
For now, yeah. He adores me, I reckon.
Yeah, he does. So you let me know how you get on with that test.
Yeah, I will.
Oh, and this is by the by, but how long will it take you to pass admission onto the course?
About 2 weeks. Why?
Nothing.
What I just administered there won't last long.
What do you mean?
The fucking fireman. He could be about to wreck her life.
And that's not jealousy or nothing.
Ash, for once, take me a fucking face value, will you?
All right, go on.
To try and keep her going. Keep her believing that Craig likes her, but really likes her.
Oh, what?
She's fucked.
Come on, do the role play. I need the practice.
Ma'am, I feel...
Ma'am?
You know, that's what you get called when you're a DI.
Fuck.
You never watch Prime Suspect?
Go on.
Ma'am, I feel I'm being discriminated against in workplace.
I'm very sorry to hear that, Constable. It's a matter I take very seriously. On what grounds?
My race, ma'am.
What are you going to do, the gay campus?
I could do both at the same time. Gain a few pounds, I'll throw fat in the equation and all.
Well, I'm a female.
I'm blonde.
Do you reckon we're both talking?
Yeah, it's your former union.
Yeah, what's this?
Rashid's to let with the FIU.
We don't need a thud. Why are we taking the trauma magnet out with us?
It's all part of Operation Maxine.
Is Ryan praying on your mind?
No, not even slightly.
You've been for a whole pack of 20 and we're only halfway through the shift.
It's meant to be us watching you for signs of stress.
Woman, 83, fallen at home.
Man down.
Any more?
Front door heavily locked, 5-2 in attendance.
Carl, I love you. Operation Maxine is a go.
Talk about insecure.
Who?
Woman, 83. She's got every lock and bar behind that door known to man. Good job her heart's not gone.
Right.
Did you want something?
Maxine.
Come again?
I just wanted to say that I'm really pleased that she's happy.
Oh. Thanks.
Yeah.
You and her go way back, yeah? Mm. She's dead nice.
Yeah.
I just don't know, you know? I think, well, I can't really see it working out somehow.
But you've got to give it a chance. I mean, don't do anything hasty.
Oh, no, I won't. I'll give it a chance, but...
Gaffer! It's not fudging.
Right, let's try a different approach. Mick, don't get a sledgehammer. I'm
going to take this. Hiya. How'd it go with the Chief Super?
Yeah. Well, actually, it was pretty close to purgatory, but, you know...
What happens next?
I've got the big self-test appraisal thing on Friday.
Which you will walk.
Yeah.
Good. Good, that's more like it. You'll be a DI in no time. Oh, incidentally, I just ran into your Craig just now.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Not very good with the verbal clues, is he?
Oh, you can say that again.
Yeah, well, it's all there, though.
What is?
The whole, you know, butterflies in the stomach, can't live without you sort of thing. I know OCD sufferers when I see them.
Are you just saying that?
No. He's nervous. You've made the big fireman nervous. You remember that when you see him.
I will. All right, well, I'll see you.
See you, Maxine.
Weird.
What is?
I have never seen you do something so completely selfless before.
I don't often get the opportunity.
No. Just not sure how selfless an actor actually is.
How do you mean?
If he really isn't interested, then you're expecting it to end. And when it does, you'll realise what a white knight you've been all along, buoying her up so she can pass the test.
There may be some truth in that.
Fair enough.
It doesn't make me a bad person.
No. Pretty much everything else you do does, but not this. Can we stop somewhere to buy some fags, please?
Oh, give your lungs a fucking break and call Ryan.
I thought we'd have a bottle of Chablis with this.
What? Oh, sure. That's wine, right, yeah?
Yeah, white wine. Nice white wine. Fucking pricey white wine.
That were gorgeous.
Oh, thanks.
Yeah. Like you.
Smooth talker.
So, let's recap. Last time we met, we just got to the part where you were enthusing about me and my, oh yeah, big black dick. I think that was the ground we were covering, wasn't it?
Do you really think I'm gorgeous?
Yeah. Yeah, I do. I think you're well fit, dead attractive.
I always thought my sister was a pretty one.
Okay, basically, I misread the signals.
Well, either I'm really crap at sending signals, or you need glasses.
It was just stupid talk. The fantasy stuff.
You know, I'm not being some arsey queen here. You really hurt my feelings. You tapped into something fairly important.
I get that now. In fact, I would have got it then if I hadn't been so pished.
Pished.
Do you want to watch one of your films?
What, one of my arty films? I don't know why I got into them. It's self-improvement, you know. Honestly, you date them, really.
And I'm sorry. Really.
It's fine.
It's not going to happen, is it, me and you?
No.
Can we at least be mates then, do you think?
Mates, then.
How about we go to the bedroom?
Yeah, go on.
Because I want to take my knickers down and receive some stern correction.
Are you sure it's Kane?
Hello, Maxine. Where are you?
I'm in the loo. I've got to keep it down.
And he's in the...
He's in the bedroom, yeah.
Interesting role reversal we've got going on here.
How do you mean?
Don't matter.
Look, I'm trying and I'm just not getting anything.
Craig is the most tongue-tied bloke I've ever met.
Yeah, we've established that.
My guess is that he's worried that you're too clever for him.
Yeah?
I mean, think about it. You read, you make yourself watch all those fucking films. He's a simple man. It's going to be intimidating. He's stressed out.
This is what fucking love does to you. It's like somebody's turned the light on and all my insecurities have come, like, crawling out the dark.
Lucky you, so have his.
Yeah, OK, that works. You're a genius.
Of course.
All right, I better get back to him.
Good luck tomorrow.
All right, night, Stuart.
Not night, Maxine.
Are you sure you have what it takes to be a detective inspector?
I am, sir, yes. All my appraisals have been excellent.
Yes, but those are the views of external observers. What do you think?
I have a lot of confidence in who I am, sir.
And who exactly is that?
That were marginally less painful than root canal work.
So you thrashed it out with Ryan and then just decided to be mates?
Yeah.
How revoltingly civilised.
I'm just following your example, actually.
In what sense?
I'm quite kind of happy on my own. Although...
Although what?
It's just that, look, from an outsider's perspective, we could be construed as a pair of lonely losers.
Who is this outsider? Bring him to me now, and I'll meet this nosy cunt.
Great. I'll go and check the tire pressure in the ambulance.
They just called.
Well?
So I got on the course. Hey, look. I couldn't have done it without your help, so...
Oh, that's substantially true.
Hey, do you want to go for a drink later, after work?
Yeah. Yeah. Of course.
I've got to go, so...
Do you realise this could be it? Your chance tonight?
My chance to restore the status quo. Back to being mates?
Exactly.
Hiya!
Hey, what about this one, eh?
Indeed. Indeed, she's electrifying, literally.
Detective Inspector.
Well, not yet.
Yeah, but you'll get there, no problem.
What you are?
Orange and soda, please. Pint.
You sure?
We're celebrating.
Yeah, thanks. So, things going well?
Yeah, they are. Yeah, to be honest, it was a bit shaky for a while, but it's insecurities, you know.
Hers?
No, mine. The thing is, she's dead clever.
Fuck.
What?
Nothing.
Proper intellectual.
Reads books, foreign films.
Yeah, all that stuff. I started to feel she was only after me for the sex, but... Well, this is how clever she is. She worked me out. Sat me down and talked me through it.
Really pleased.
Yeah. And she's not after an Einstein either, apparently. Which is good, so... Yeah, it's fine.
Great.
It's weird. I can't stop thinking about her. I can't get her out of my head, you know?
Yeah. I do.
Love, eh?
Yeah. Serotonin, actually.
What?
Serotonin. It's a neural messenger in the brain.
I failed biology at school.
Sometimes I wish I'd failed it, too.
There you go.
Gosh, this is nice.
Happy days.
Yeah.
To Maxine.
Indeed.
Cheers. So?
Oh, well, sorry, I've got to go.
Oh, already?
Yeah, I promised Ash. He's a bit down in the dumps.
Oh. Ryan?
Yeah, he seems to have subtly offended him somehow, so better go and cheer him up.
Quite the hero, aren't you?
Yes, that's me.
You got my message then?
Back to being mates for Maxine.
Exactly as anticipated. Yay for friendship. Don't have to have one of those left here.
You don't smoke?
I think about taking it up, actually.
Lungs are overrated organs.
So?
What do you want to do?
We could sit over a coffee, break over what happened, assess where we went wrong, learn from our mistakes.
Or go into total denial and get completely full-on rat-arse drunk.
Exactly. Mistakes? What mistakes? I don't make mistakes.
You get the first round then.
No.
You get the first round in. I got the last round in. It's your turn.
See, for all this fucking free therapy and giving you the least to do by mine. Where's Rashid, by the way?
I don't know. It's going to happen.
I'm looking for Stuart.
That's me.
Your father died 2 weeks ago. How do you feel?
It's the funny thing. Don't know how I feel yet. All right, mate.
Why?
You don't think he's just homeless, then? He doesn't smell homeless.
I'd like a permanent place here.
What are you doing?
Working.
Hey, you should be in number four with that girl.
This is Stuart.
Your brother.
Well, fuck a duck. You're genuinely upset, aren't you?
My dad's dead. Our dad's dead. Does that mean anything to you?
No.
I'm not fucking vulnerable.
Oh, of course you're not. I mean, he must have misread the signals.
Happy birthday.
Oh, thank you. You like her, don't you?
She's with someone.
She's with a man who's doing a very good impersonation of a bell.
Spare a thought for the porters, receptionists, cleaners and security guards who also experience the traumas of 24 Hours in A&E, Wednesday at 9. Next tonight, two brothers fight over their mother's house. Coming up, Micah.